Roll along is a Bowling Green motto. Well, Ohio men's basketball would love to roll along this four-game winning streak into five by beating Bowling Green on the road on Saturday. I'm Russ Eisenstein, and this Bobcat basketball report on Cameron Feels Good is presented by CareSource. You're not wrong when you're saying, I'm looking at the schedule. It's Ohio and Eastern Michigan at the Roundhouse on Saturday, right? Well, COVID concerns with the Eagle program forced that postponement, and this Rubik's Cube of a scheduling scenario continues to twist and turn, and you move up the BG game on the road later in the month to this Saturday. That frees up some spots to potentially play one or multiple of the postponed games that Ohio had from earlier in the year against Northern Illinois, against Miami, or against EMU. We'll see how it all shakes out. Speaking of moving and shaking, the Bobcats have 11 wins, 7 in league play, and there are a lot of concrete reasons why the Cats are on the roll that they're on.
There are lessons in losses, and the 10-point home loss to Kent State on January 16th showed the Cats what they needed to work on, defense and rebounding. Lessons certainly learned. The Flashes shot 57% and out-rebounded Ohio 45-21. And the wins that followed over Ball State, Western Michigan, Buffalo, and Central Michigan on Tuesday night, those teams were held to 42% or less from the field. The Chippewas shot 38%, and Ohio owned the glass in each of those four games, plus 11 against the Cardinals and plus 12 against the Chippewas. Add to that Ohio's off-the-charts two-point efficiency. Bangs are fun, and the Bobs are still banging, but they just can't be stopped inside the arc. The top shooting team in the MAC went 28 of 35 from two against CMU. That's just nuts. Dwight Wilson has a PhD in proficiency. He's 31 of his last 36 from the field. That's mind-blowing. He and Jason Preston had double-doubles in Mount Pleasant. As for the Falcons, the preseason MAC faves are trying to fly through turbulence. They've lost five in a row. They're 1-6 in the last seven and are 10-8 and 6-6. It didn't get better on Wednesday night when BG led Western Michigan 2-0 and never led again in losing to the Broncos 76-70. There are lessons learned from Ohio's game one loss to the Falcons in Athens on December the 30th, too. Ohio fell 83-75. It was up 10 at halftime, but guarding without fouling was an issue. The Falcons went 36 of 38 from the line. Ohio's doing their defensive duty now, better than they did then, so it will be fun to see what the Bobs can do on D against BG.
So it's the Bobcats and Falcons, and Rob Cornelius and I will roll on up to the Stroh Center for you to infotain on the Ohio Sports Network from Learfield IMG College with our pregame coverage starting at 4:30 and the tip at 5. It's also on ESPN3. Think about this. If Ohio gets the win, that's 5 in a row. John Gross and the Akron Zips come to town on Tuesday next week for the 700th game all-time in Convocation Center history. The game will be on national TV. We certainly wish that you could be here with us. Man, this roundhouse would be rumbling for sure. I'm getting goosebumps thinking about it. We can't wait to have you back here, but hopefully you get a little bit of Cat coverage through our infotainment on the camera, on TV, and on radio, so you experience it a little bit. But we'll worry about that next week, Bobcats and Zips. First things first, it's the Bobcats and BG on Saturday. And our report is presented by CareSource. Socially spaced from Zach Roberts. I'm Russ Eisenstein, and this is Bobcat TV.